Hey guys, it's Jeff Lafferty, and it's ArtCast number 389, I believe. And I'm just sitting here painting a commission for a guy. This is for that. I think I told you guys about it. It's he does the little lead figures. His company's called Forge of Ice, and this is kind of a cover for a little book he's putting out with the figures. So I got it kind of zoomed in on the part that I have done, and it's a piece that right now I'm painting in acrylics, but I think I'm going to go over parts of it with oil because he really likes that Frazetta type look. And not that I can paint as good as Frazetta, but I can kind of give it a little bit more of a lush look. And that's what I'm doing. So before I start, I want to throw something out to everybody that watches my videos and kind of like my collectors and stuff like that. I'm going to be selling this piece this month. So I'm going to be selling this piece right here. This is actually a piece I did back in 95, actually. And it was a cover for one of the comics I was on, and I dug out a copy. This one right here, called X-Men Books of Ascani. I actually did the back cover too, and some inside stuff. But I held on to this thing for like years and never have sold it. And I don't know, I think I'm going to sell it this month because I want to try to dedicate a little bit more time to doing my comic. So hopefully this thing will bring some pretty decent money. When I put up published work on eBay in the past, it seems like the collectors tend to find it, and it goes for some good money. And so that's kind of what I'm hoping. So that will be up on eBay this week, and it might be up when this video goes up. I'm not quite sure if I'll have time to get it up tomorrow or not. Yeah, so I was just sitting here and working on this piece, and I realized that it's Sunday night and I need to do a video for tomorrow. and so here, that's what I'm doing. I really don't have much to. You know, I haven't really thought about like what to say. I was actually getting kind of tired of painting, and I was going to go to bed. And now I'm sitting here like trying to think of something to say. But anyway, I was kind of talking about this piece, and I think I'm going to try to throw oil over top of like the acrylic painting. I've done these before, and usually what I do is I do it pretty much the same way. I draw it, you know, I kind of ink over it with some kind of pen, and then I paint, you know, in acrylics, and then at some point I switch to oils and I try to make it a little bit more lush. And that's pretty much what I'm going to try with this one. The only thing I'm doing this time that's a little different is I was trying to bring in some of the the comic book look that I've been going for, where I spray with some grays and work up from the grays. So we'll see how it all kind of comes out. I'm liking how the figure comes out. This guy, I know he's kind of ugly and weird looking, but he's kind of like the monster in the piece, obviously. And I'm kind of liking how this is kind of painting up. I almost think this could kind of be like finished without any kind of oil paints. But I think like the background's really going to need that subtlety, and so I think I'm going to like just do a mix and try to make it like just all work together. I have like I'm trying to do like two different jobs this week, and it's just really hard. I don't like when I have to switch back and forth constantly, and that's just what I've been doing this week. So hopefully I get this one done. I mean, I was hoping I'd get it done tomorrow, but it's probably going to be a few more days. So what should I talk about? I didn't really think about much for this video. I just, didn't want to break my promise to not do daily videos, so I was like, I gotta do a video tonight. I was thinking the other day about how much I hate the YouTube algorithm. I could talk a little bit about this. Not so much because, you know, I think it's like YouTube's against my videos or something. Even though I do kind of think they are. But I hate, like, the stuff they serve up in your sidebar, you know? It's so fucking lame, you know? Like, the other day, I was, you know, come on YouTube to watch somebody I subscribe to, you know? And then in my sidebar comes up, like, all these videos of how to make, like, homemade gesso. And I'm like, you know, I can just see that it just looks stupid. And I don't click on it. And then I'm like sitting there watching the different videos, and it's like it just constantly keeps coming up. You know, it's just like it's constantly in the sidebar in this like recommended tab for me or whatever. You know, it's like YouTube has decided that I need to learn how to make, you know, homemade gesso, you know. And I can just see it's like some of these like old lady type videos, you know, it's like these crafter type broads. And finally, I just decided to click on it just to see, like, you know, what this is. And it's like, you know, it's like some old lady making gesso out of like white glue. What was it? It was like white glue, white paint, and like white glue, like, you know, Elmer's glue, and then white paint, and then baby powder. And I'm like, what the, you know what I mean? Like, what the fuck? I mean, seriously, you're gonna trust your fucking painting on like that kind of stuff, you know? I mean, I don't know how to make gesso. I'm not an expert chemist or something like that, but my guess, you know, I mean, I know like the old masters put like marble dust in their gesso. And so that they were, you know, when they were painting on their wooden panels, it was almost like painting on a slab of marble. But anyway, this lady's throwing in baby powder. And as soon as I click on it, you know, just like as soon as I click on it, I notice like in the sidebar is like six more fucking videos about like this baby powder gesso stuff, you know, that just like pops up because like YouTube suddenly knows that now that I have watched one, you know, I'm like indoctrinated into like this cult of fucking baby powder gesso. And I'm just like, oh my god. And then it also makes me realize that, like, you know, this is like the, you know, the whole thing with like the how to draw an eye, you know, video. If you've ever looked on YouTube and look up something like how to draw an eye, like there's, you know, every freaking artist, every channel has this stupid, you know, how to draw an eye video. And it's like, you know, it's that old thing of like, the thing I'm always bitching about is like, you know, somewhere on fucking YouTube, there's like a how to draw an eye video that's got like a million views, and every freaking artist goes and, you know, sees that video and goes, hey, I should make a how to draw an eye video. And then they make it, and they all just suck, you know what I mean? They're all just like, it's just, it's, you know, they just get more worthless than the last one. But anyway, here's like another one. The other day I was like, you know, tooling around YouTube again. I see this video, God, what was it called? It was like such a clickbaity title. And like when I see the clickbaity titles, I don't ever watch those videos because I hate those clickbaity titles, you know. I can't stand, you know, when I see, you know, 10 tips to blah, 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 and, you know, whatever. Or like people that like do the controversial kind of tips, and you know, I get it, they're trying to get hits, but it's also, it just sucks, you know. And I personally don't like watching them, but anyway, this one you could just tell is like click fucking bait, you know. It was something like, you know, I quit my job 2 years ago, and you know, this is what happened, or something like that. I quit my job to do art full time, and 2 years ago, and this is what happens. But it was something else. It was better than that. But basically, that was the gist of it. And so I'm sitting there, and I go, like, God, I gotta watch this one, right? Like, I quit my job 3 years ago, right? And if here's like another guy that did the same thing, I kind of wanna, you know, I guess I kind of want to see what it's about. So anyway, I click it, and it's like this younger dude, and I'm not gonna link his channel or anything, or because I don't want to fight with anybody, or you know. So if this guy ever, you know, suspects that I'm talking about him, he won't know for sure. He's not really like anybody I've ever seen on YouTube before, and he's only like, I clicked his channel, and he's only got like, you know, 30 videos or something, which is really weird because like all of his videos I noticed were, you know, really low, like, you know, less than 1,000 hits, and then like this video had like 50,000 hits. So it's like obviously, you know, YouTube is like serving it up in the sidebar like a, you know, hot soup dish or something. So anyway, I clicked this video that, you know, YouTube has decided that I should like, and it's like I said, it's like this younger guy, and he starts telling the story of how he decided like 2 years ago to quit his job and try to make art his full-time deal. Okay, so I'm back. Since I'm using this camera, I kind of got to keep a timer on what I'm talking about so the card doesn't run out. It's just hard to shoot with this camera. It's like, it gives a good image, but it's like, you know, I have to work with these cards, and it just, I don't know, breaks my train of thought, you know. When I'm doing the Patreon videos, I actually shoot just with my webcam. And so it's a little bit more free flow and stuff. It's a little plug for my Patreon. Everybody should go check it out. I'm doing weekly videos there, or like daily videos, you know, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. Anyway, back to the point is like, when I started listening to this guy's video, I just was kind of like, you know, you just immediately get the sense of like, I don't know if he's got, you know, if he's got a plan to like, you know, make it. But then of course, you know, the title of the video is like, you know, quit 2 years ago, here's what's going to happen. But I guess I'm like already suspecting that the guy might not have made it, just because, you know, it just didn't sound like he really had like a clue, you know. And he goes on telling the story of like what happened. So like the first thing he talks about is, you know, he just talks about having like all this money saved up before he quit, which I've heard different people go like, you know, that's what you should do. And, you know, I don't disagree with that. I think if you have a lot of money saved up, it's going to be easier. You know, like when I quit my job, I had like $300 in the bank, you know, and it was freaking tough. But I also think that, you know, more importantly than having a bunch of money saved up, you gotta have like a plan on like where you're gonna get those first dollars, you know. You can't be just like, you know, I wanna do art. You know, it's like that's not good enough, you know what I mean? It's gotta be like, I know that I can sell this, or I know that I can freelance here, or I know, you know what I mean? You have to have already started like building your base, you know, before you're like out there, or else like, how, you know, how are you gonna do it? You're gonna run out of money before you get there. Anyway, this kid, he saved up like, it sounded like a hell of a lot of money before he quit. And then of course, like, he's with some girl, and he's like, my girlfriend, you know, is going to college, and she's getting her, you know, master's degree and something, and you know, like, she's had financial problems, and it's like, this is something that, you know, she needs, and blah blah. So anyway, like, basically gave her like a huge chunk of cash for her, you know, college, which, you know, okay. And then there was something else, like, right after that that happened, like, the refrigerator broke, or, you know, something that seemed like, to me, I don't know, it sounded like one of those things where, like, if I would have been, like, you know, if it broke with me, and I was trying to, you know, start my living as an artist, I'd been like, well, that's just going to be broke for a while. But he went ahead and fixed it, and that took a bunch of more money. And then he goes off, and he starts talking about, I can't really remember like what it all was, but he just kind of like started to talk about, you know, learning art, and like how, you know, he needed to learn this and learn that, and all this learning stuff, you know, Which is like great, you know, if you got time to learn, you know, that's like what we all should be doing, like all the time. But then, like, I mean, for Christ's sake, you know, like once you quit your job, like it's fucking game on. It's like, you know, shortest route to, you know, a paycheck from somebody or something, right? You got to sell something, you got to do something. Somehow you got to start bringing the cash in. I never really talked anything about that. And then like I'm, you know, and this is like a freaking 20-minute video, so I'm like sitting here drawing and drawing, and you know, and then all of a sudden it's like I realize, like, no, well, he's wrapping it up. It's like the end of the video, and he's kind of like throwing out his plans to make money from like here on out. So it's like he never really, like, even, you know, told the audience or me or whatever whether he was even still like functional or not. And like at the very end, like, you know, he starts to talk about, you know, like what he was gonna do to move forward to make money. And like right off the bat, it was like, I can't remember what the other one was, but it was like he said two things, but one of them was like, you know, he wanted to start making courses. You know what I mean? It's just like, oh, you know, it's like that's like just such a go-to for like so many, I don't know, so many people that just sort of can't figure it out. Is like they immediately go like, okay, you know, let's make a course and sell it. And it's like, you know, you've been like out on your own for like 2 years, and now you're gonna tell everybody else how to do it. And you know, it's like it doesn't sound like you're even doing it yourself. I mean, I hope it's working for him, but I kind of think, I mean, if it is, he's like probably living off his parents' money or something, because it just didn't sound like the dude's got a fucking clue on how to make it, you know. But speaking of courses, I was actually thinking about doing one myself. I know that's, I probably sound hypocritical like that. It's like, oh, Jeff, you just bitched on people who teach courses, and now you're talking about doing one yourself. But I actually, you know, I was thinking about like Patreon and what people want from me, because I want to make Patreon like my thing. I want to make like $1,000 a month on Patreon. And get it so that, like, I can do this comic and have time to do it and, like, take it to where I want to take it. You know what I mean? I want to, like, have time to get back into the animation and do what I want to do there. You know? And it's like, it's just selling art, you know, just selling one piece, one piece, one piece. It's like, you can obviously make a living at it. I've done it for, you know, three plus years now, plus like, you know, all the other times I've quit my job and done it for a certain amount of time. But it's like, you know, the thing is you're always sort of, you know, I don't know, keeping the wolves from the door kind of thing. You're just always up against this fight of like paying the rent, you know, or paying, you know, the mortgage or whatever. You're just always like just making enough to get to the next day, you know, the next month, just making enough to get to the next month. And that's fine. I'm sure I could just do this, you know, endlessly. But I think that, like, you know, in order to bring in, like, you know, the creative type stuff that I want to do, it's like crowdfunding has got to become like a part of my income, you know, like a major part of my income. And anyway, I was thinking about like ideas for Patreon. And I was thinking, like, one of the things that I've heard from people that watch my videos and stuff, like, many times, is like they want, like, some sort of course, like, some sort of in-depth kind of thing that, like, shows them how I, like, paint, how I draw. And, like, that's a big complaint I hear, like often on my videos is like, well, you don't start from the beginning. You don't do this part of the painting. You're doing this part. You're not doing the part that I'm interested in, you know, and all that. And I think also, like, just the fact of, like, you know, what I did right there, where I just, you know, got off bitching about somebody else's video, it's like, I don't talk enough about art, you know? So it's like, they want a tutorial from me. But even though I've done, like, you know, kind of tutorial-esque type videos in the past, it's like I can't do it that way every time and have any kind of a channel, right? So anyway, like the course thing kind of came into my mind, and I started thinking, well, you know, what if I do that? What if I put together like an in-depth kind of like video course that's like, you know, 5 videos long, you know, a couple hours on each video, and I paint like a piece of movie art start to finish, and I show you guys like every freaking step of the thing I do, you know. And then I you know, put it up for like a price, and then I go like, okay, you can either buy it or you can get on Patreon and download it, or be, you know what I mean, you basically, everybody on Patreon just gets the stuff. And so that's kind of like something I was kind of thinking about, but I don't know if that would work either, you know. I've really been like kind of going around looking at other people's Patreons and just like, you know, really examining like what seems to bring people in, you know. I mean, like I was talking about the not safe for work stuff last time, and that does seem to bring people in, though I don't really want to go there, I think, with my art, you know. I mean, I don't mind drawing nudes, but I don't know. What do you guys think? I mean, let me just throw it out to you guys. What do I do, or what do I don't do, that you want, that you get on there, you know, and give me $5 a month, and also not just give it to me, but actually, you know, because the other thing about Patreon is I want to make it like, I don't want to make it like charity, you know what I mean? I want it to be like a transaction. I want it to be just like going and buying a print from my store. It's like, you give me $5 a month, and I give you something back for that. Yeah, I'll just throw that out. It's like, what do you want out of me that I don't give that would be worth $5 a month? You know, throw it out. I would actually like to hear it, and you know, it's like I won't be uncool about it. Even if I think your idea is stupid, I won't, you know, publicly humiliate you or anything on the videos or something. But it might be some good information for me, I guess. I guess we'll wrap it up there. Hopefully that'll make a decent video for Monday. Like I said, I'm doing daily videos on Patreon, so I'm going to do Monday, Friday videos on YouTube. I'm doing Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday on Patreon. You can go over there and watch them. On Patreon, you also get a chance to win a free drawing, which I'm going to go for every month. And then I also give 20% discount on merchandise, prints, and stuff that are in my store. And what else? Don't forget about that X-Men piece that's going to be on eBay this week. Hopefully that'll make me some cash. And I'll see you guys next time.